making banquets in the wilderness with two fish and five loaves of bread. And then he came out of hiding and he began to teach, oh Lord, what it really meant to be a part of the kingdom of God. But oh, when he came out of hiding, they got upset with him and crucified him on an old rugged cross. But oh, I'm glad tonight that he died for our sins. He died because we were wretched. He died because we were enemies of God. And they hid him one more time by putting him in a borrowed tomb. He was hidden, Shiloh, all night Friday night. He was hidden all day Saturday. He was hidden all Saturday night. But when the time was right, on Sunday morning, he came out of hiding with all power in his hand. Now, good evening, y'all. But do me one favor, please. Turn and take a neighbor's hand and say, neighbor, I don't know what you're waiting on. I don't know what hasn't happened yet. But neighbor, let me remind you that you can't hurry God. You just got to wait. Be patient and give him time. No matter how long it takes, he's a God that you can't hurry, but he'll be there. Don't you worry. He may not come when you want him to come, but he's always. Would you encourage one more neighbor? Would you put your arm around one more neighbor and say, neighbor, keep on waiting on God, because they that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. You will mount up on wings like eagles. You will run and not get weary. You will walk and not faint. Wait on him, 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 yeah.
Say this every now and then. God wants to know, can you praise him for all that he's done? If you don't mind, will you shake somebody's hand, hold their hand, and say, neighbor, excuse me if I get a little noisy. Excuse me if I get a little loud. But oh, neighbor, you're sitting beside a praiser this morning. When I think about the goodness of Jesus and all he's done for me, I got to praise him. If I gotta do it all by myself, have I got a witness here? This morning that I know how to praise him. I got one more thing I need to tell you, the Bible says that when she walked in, she came in like this. When Jesus touched her, she was like this. But before she left, she did this. Y'all ain't happy. She walked in like this. Jesus touched her, she was like this. But before she left, she did this. Will you lean over? Grab your neighbor's hand. Everybody grab a hand and say, neighbor, I remember when I was bent over. I was looking like this. All I could see was dirt. But one day, Jesus laid his hands on me, made me like this. And that's why I do this. Is there anybody come to praise my Lord? Is there anybody know the Lord been good? If you know he's been good, wave your hand. Say yes. I'm getting out of here. But squeeze your neighbor hand. Everybody squeeze a hand and say, neighbor, do you feel that? Do you feel that? That's what a miracle feel like. That's what deliverance feel like. That's what a testimony feel like. Yes, yes, yes. Can we try it one more time? Look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, let me show you my testimony. Oh, man, show him one more time. Yes, yes, yes. Ain't God all right, y'all? Ain't God all right, y'all? Can you praise him? Can you praise him? Come on. Take about 20 seconds and give God the best praise you. Hey.
Yes. stay dead. They buried him all night Friday, buried him all day Saturday. But early, I said early, early, early. I gotta holler one time for the doctor. Early. Somebody say.
A good look at me now, because at the end of 2012 I won't look like this. God's got more ministry, God's got more blessings, God's got more breakthroughs. I preach to myself up in here. Is there anybody here who can say, Lord, give me strength just to keep on walking? I may not get a new job, but with the little money I have, give me a little strength to keep on going. I may not get a new husband, but God, give me new little strength to keep on going. Shake somebody's hand. Say, neighbor, I know it's gotten rough for you. I know you had tears to cry, but neighbor, y'all ain't talking to your neighbor. Take them by the hand and hold them with some Holy Ghost. Hold their hand with some power. Don't hold it like a dead fish. Look them dead in the face. Say, excuse me, I don't mean to bother you, but you ain't seen nothing yet. You had to cry, but it ain't over. It was rough, but it ain't over. You had to push through, but it ain't over. Is there anybody here that can praise God? Because he'll keep you strong enough just to make it through. He'll keep you through a divorce. He'll keep you with no money. He'll keep you when your children crazy. Is there anybody here? No, God can keep you. You ought to say yes. Lift your hands up and say, Lord, in 2012, I'm just asking for one thing. Keep me in your hands. Keep me in your protection. And won't God do it? Hadn't God done it? Won't he take care of you? So be not dismayed. Whatever betide, God, he will take care of you. Beneath his wings of love abide, God will take care of you. So if you see me shouting this year, it's because God has given me some reasons to give him some praise. I got 7 reasons why I praise him. Number one, he's been good to me. Number two, he's been good to me. Number three, he's been good to me. Number four, y'all keep sitting there. This between me and God. Number four, you've been good to me. Number five, he's been good to me. Number six, you've been good to me. And I got one more reason why I give you praise. You have been good to me. Is there anybody here God's been good to? Is there anybody here glad God kept you? You wanted to give up, but he kept you in it. You wanted to give in, but he held your hand. Somebody shout yes. Shout yes. That's all I got. That's all I got for you. But when I start thinking about it, all the times I had enough, I was tired of church. I was tired of ministry. I got tired and weary. There are more hateful people in the church than any other place in the world. But just when I wanted to give up sitting under my tree, can I tell you what God did? God allowed him to sit under a tree. And I don't know what kind of tree Elijah was sitting under, but I know of another tree. One Friday night, they took my Jesus up on a tree called Calvary. And whenever I get weak, I got to learn to lean on the tree. I got to learn to lean on the tree. Well, why do you lean on that tree? My grandma said, there is a fountain filled with blood, drawn from Emmanuel's veins, and sinners plunge beneath that flood, lose all their guilty stains. Why do you lean on the tree? Because somebody was singing. They said it was at the cross. At the cross where I first saw the light, and the burdens of my heart rolled away. Shake your neighbor's hand one last time in this service. Look them in the face. Say, neighbor, it may get rough. Neighbor, it may get hard. But learn how to lean on the tree. Jesus died for you and me. Anybody glad about it? Say yes. Say yes.